各位弟兄姐妹们平安。
Peace to you, brothers and sisters.
觉得在每次饼杯祷告的时候，我觉得大家献上口中的祭是非常宝贵的。
I feel like every time prayers during breaking the bread, all these prayers are so precious.
刚才奇迹中有一位弟兄祷告到说
，There's a brother that prayed.
我们被许多在世上美好的事物吸引。
That we're attracted by many attractive things of the world.
但愿是主的荣耀吸引我们。
But may the glory of the Lord attract us.
我们在祷告之前，我们先来读一段圣经。
As a read a passage from the scripture.
列王记上十一章一到十七节。
First Kings chapter 11.
好不好？如果有圣经的打开圣经，有手机的打开圣经，没手机的没圣经的，看一下 PowerPoint。
If you have the Bible, please turn it on, we'll open up, or if you don't, just look at the PowerPoint. 1 Kings chapter 11, verses 1 through 17.
好，翻到了，可以抬头看我。
Please lift up your head once you're there.
OK, 那我们一二三，如果讲中文的就读中文，讲英文就读英文，我们一起读，省了时间。
Read aloud both in Chinese and English together.
来，一二三。所罗门在法老的女儿之外，又宠爱许多外邦女子，就是摩押女子、亚扪女子、以东女子、西顿女子、赫人女子。论到这些国的人，耶和华曾晓谕以色列人说：“你们不可与他们往来相通，因为他们必诱惑你们的心，去随从他们的神。”所罗门却恋爱这些女子。所罗门有妃七百，都是公主；有兵三百，这些妃兵诱惑他的心。所罗门年老的时候，他的妃兵诱惑他的心，去随从别神，不效法他父亲大卫诚诚实实的顺服耶和华他的神，因为所罗门随从希顿人的女神雅斯他录和亚扪人可憎的神米勒公。所罗门行耶和华中看为恶的事，不效法他父亲大卫专心顺从耶和华。所罗门为摩押可憎的神基莫和亚摩人可憎的神。
The detestable god of Ammonites.
他为那些问自己
for all his foreign wives,
就是他娶来的妃嫔也是这样行。耶和华向所罗门发怒，因为他的心偏离向他两次显现的耶和华以色列的神。耶和华曾吩咐他不可随从别神，他却没有遵守耶和华所吩咐的。所以耶和华对他说：“你既行了这事，不遵守我吩咐你守约和律例，我必将你的国夺回，赐给你的城子。然而因你父亲大卫的缘故，我不在你。”活着的日子行这事，必从你儿子手中将国夺回。这是我不将全国夺回，要以我仆人大卫和我所选择的，还留一支支派给你儿子。耶和华是以东人哈达兴起做所罗门的敌人，他是以东的后裔。先前大卫攻击以东，元帅约押上去仗。
Earlier, when David was fighting with Edom, Joab, the commander of the army, who had gone to bear the dead, struck down all the men in Edom. Joab and all the Israelites stayed there for 6 months, until they had destroyed all the men in Edom. But Hadad, still only a boy, fled to the official, served his father. Let's have a word of prayer. Thank you, Jesus, for bringing us here. Through your word,
借着弟兄们的交通
，through the fellowship of brothers and sisters，
借着任何服事上
，through all the service，
都向我们说话
，may speak to us，
时常尊你的名为圣
，that we may call your name holy，
孩子祷告奉主的名求
，pray in the name of your son Jesus Christ，
阿门。好，我们在讲到一到十七节的时候，我们可以先回顾一下大卫。还有所罗门在之前所做的事情。
Before we jump into verses 1 through 17, let's review what David has done.
大卫在神面前被称为 the man after God's own heart.
David before God was called the man after God's own heart.
神也喜悦所罗门这位大卫的儿子。
The Lord is also pleased with the son of David, Solomon.
之后立所罗门为王。
And then made him a king.
也让所罗门建他的宫殿。
And then allowed Solomon to build his temple.
赐给他许多恩典。
Give him many blessings.
许多外邦的人，因为所罗门神赐给他智慧，尊他非常尊敬他。
Many foreigners even respect Solomon because of the wisdom given by God.
神和所罗门就在这全国得了很多很好的名誉。
And God allowed Solomon to receive many good names.
那我们现在看一下现在这个光景。
However, let's look at the situation now.
神曾应允大卫跟所罗门，如果一直遵守他们的命令的话，他的王位必巩固。
God promised David and Solomon that if they obey his commands, their kingdom will continue on.
甚至他的后裔接续做王。
And their generation will be continue to be king. 但是
前提就是要遵守神的律例。
But the requirement is for them to obey God's commands.
那我们第一节看到所罗门开始恋爱了这些外邦女子。
But then starting verse 1, King Solomon loved foreign women.
以至于他得罪神。
And then sinned against God.
神在第三节，第四节，第二节解释说，为什么不可与其他人通婚。
And in verse 2, God explained why he cannot intermarry other tribes.
因为外邦女子会诱惑他的心偏离向神。
Because the foreign women will turn their hearts against other gods.
所罗门可能听进去了。
So maybe Solomon heard about it.
却没有行出来。
But he didn't act upon it.
为什么？
Why not?
自己可能有个 desire.
Because he may have his own personal desire.
自己的肉体，自己的欲望胜过了神的命令。
The flesh, the desires of the flesh overcame the commandment of God.
神给所罗门实在许多恩典。
God has given Solomon much blessing.
就如他给他父亲一样，有许多恩典。
Just like for his father David, lots of blessings.
但是两位父子都因为贪恋了其他人的东西，或是神不想贪恋的东西，而有祸害在他们身上。
But sound like father, they both have fallen in love with things outside, given by God.
当神给我们这么多东西的时候
，When God has blessed us with so much,
在这个界内里面，我们要怎么求什么都没问题。
As long as we're within the perimeter, we can ask for anything.
但是当我们超越神的恩典之后
，But when we go beyond God's blessing,
是祸难临过来的时候
，Then trouble will come.
那我们现在看到。从第三节到第六节
，Let's look at verse 3 to verse 6。
非常非常确认说，神很多很多诫命，但这个非常清楚，神不要让以色列人族跟外邦人女人通婚。
God has many commandments, and among them, this is one of the more important ones, where God does not allow Israelites to intermarry other nations.
现在所罗门犯了这个罪。
Yes, Solomon has.Committed this crime.
之后使耶和华发怒。
And then the Lord Jehovah was angry.
所以从第九节到第四十节最后一节。
Therefore, from verse 9 all the way to the very last verse.
都来讲到这个的后果。
Talk about the consequences of such sin.
那我把这一段，尤其是这一章，我给它取名叫“神的智慧、神的恩典与人的堕落”。
The topic of my sharing is God's wisdom, God's grace, and man's folly.
为什么？因为你会觉得很奇怪是，当十七节这时候，他介绍了一个新的角色。
Why? Because verse 17, the Bible introduced a new character.
是从第十四节。
I mean from verse 14.
他兴起了以东人哈达。
The God raised up against Solomon Avatar.
在二十三节。
The Edomites.
他兴起了以利亚大的儿子利逊。
第几节？
二十三节。
And then also in verse 23, God also raised up against Solomon, Rezon.
之后也介绍所罗门的臣子耶罗伯安。
And then goes on to Solomon's son.
他们将来是来毁坏跟夺取大卫后裔所拥有的祝福。
And then later they become Solomon's adversaries and destroyed and took away David's kingdom.
为什么？
What happened? Why?
因为他们忘记了神的恩典。
Why? Because they forgot God's grace.
他们跟从了自己的欲望。
They have followed the desires of their own heart.
他们被他们觉得很好的事物给吸引了。
They were attracted by something that's really attractive.
所罗门可能忘记当初对神的爱。
And Solomon has lost his initial love.
他可能忘记他当时爱耶和华甚至将这些材料然后准备这些很浩大工程建造就是为了给神。
Solomon loved the Lord so much that he used all these precious material to build God his temple.
我其实是室内设计。
I'm an interior designer.
然后我有段时间我在十一章前面他在讲他怎么建造这个圣殿的时候。
And then before chapter 11, when we're using talking about how they build this temple.
是非常非常奢华的材料。
It's really, really expensive material.
其实我看了我眼睛都是就觉得哇。就是如果家里光是你如果一个家具能照它的材料做的话，那会是值好几千美金的。
And if even if you have one piece of furniture that's built based on these temple materials, it'll worth thousands of dollars.
光是现在用象牙做的一个旗子
，If you have a chess piece made out of ivory,
就可以卖很多钱了。
It will be worth a lot of money.
何况整个殿用象牙铺上的。
Let alone the whole temple was laced with ivory.
用黄金打造的盾牌。
And then a shield made out of gold.
这些原本的企图心都是很好的。
All this, the initial desire was great.
随着时间的变化，随着人心的变化。
But with the change of time and the change of man's heart.
忘记了神不变的恩典。
They have forgotten God's unchanging grace.
所以接下来之前所做的事情都被毁坏了。
Therefore, all the good that has been done was destroyed.
圣殿被毁坏了。
The temple was destroyed.
盾牌被抢了
，The shield was stolen，
象牙被烧了
，The ivory was burnt，
以色列的名也没了
，Simplify a person's life，
也可以看成一个世界的堕落
，And also the fall， the downfall of the world。
我们都是所罗门
，We are all like Solomon，
我们都是大卫
，We're all like David，
同时我们也是哈达
，Also we're also 哈达。
我们当初可能做一件事情的时候，我们有很好的企图心。
Initially, if we want to do something, we may have a good intention.
随着服侍，随着我们自己的诡诈。
But the services on top of our skewedness.
整个 quality 变质了。
Then we change the quality.
之后，因为我们把自己当成我们自己的神。
Because we have made us into our own gods.
灾祸临到我们。
Then trouble came upon us.
接下来，如果你会发现，列王记上、列王记下、历代志上、历代志下，都有一个非常。Familiar 循环的故事。
Then, if you look at First Kings, Second Kings, First Chronicle, Second Chronicle, there's this familiar cycle.
一个王纪念神的恩典。
When a king remembers God's grace,
遵守神的律例
follows His commands,
神赐福给他
God will bless him.
救他们脱离外邦人的手。
And then lead them away from the foreigners.
他们的子孙接待他们的王位。
And then their children will follow on the throne.
忘记了神的恩典。
But yeah, when they forget God's grace,
忘记了神当初从以色列救拔出埃及的这个恩典。
When they forget the grace that how God led the people out of Egypt,
继续拜金牛犊，继续拜巴利。
They continue to worship the golden calf or the Baal.
继续效法其他外邦人的神。
Worship other gods.
神又降灾祸给他。
Then God's anger will fall.
在这里十七章，然后从十七节左右这边开始，神介绍了三个。角色
And then starting from verse 17, God introduces three characters.
来夺取毁坏大卫后裔的福分
To take away and destroy David's blessing.
这并不是一天兴起的
This does not happen in one day.
他可以当他在第十七节左右，他已经跟你介绍背景了。大卫在杀以东人的时候，哈达存留了。
For example, verse 17, where Hadad was still a boy when David came in and killed the Edomites.
以至于之后，他有这个精力，他有这个时间去存留他的兵力，还有愤怒，然后去给他发在大卫的后裔身上。
Therefore, this boy had plenty of time to vent his anger in David's descendants.
这个事情一定会发生的。
This event will happen.
但结果是由我们自己决定的。
But then the result is determined by us.
如果所罗门继续好好敬畏神的话，我相信神会因为所罗门的关系眷顾以色列人，让他胜过哈达。
If Solomon continues to worship and obey God, I believe God will prevent this event from happening.
但是因为所罗门他不效法神的律例
，But because Solomon failed to obey God's command,
他不敬畏耶和华。
He did not worship God.
他给恶者留了破口。
He left room for the evil one.
接下来他的国必被掳掠。
Therefore his kingdom was taken away.
所以其实我觉得神特别有智慧，是他其实已经把这个事情放在其中了。
I believe God is so wise because he had placed the seed in the history.
但是无论我们怎么去乱搞、瞎搞
，But no matter how what we do,
神的名都会被彰显。
His name will be magnified.
在这些书上面，我们都看过，神会差派先知跟一位王说，这些外邦人要过来攻打你，但是我会帮助你战胜，让他们知道我是以色列的神。
In the Bible, God has sent many prophets to warn the Israelites, saying, "Your nation will be under attack."
神从来没有，神从来没有说我会让外邦人知道你这个王是以色列的王。神从来没有跟一个王说，我会让外邦人知道你这个王是以色列的王。
Oh, God never said to the foreigners. God never told the foreigners that this is the king of Israel.
注意，神只有说我会让以色列，我会让外邦人知道我是以色列的神。
Oh, God only said foreigners will know I am the God of Israel.
我们整个活的利率都是以神为中心。
We live with God in our center.
但是我们把神抛在中心之外的时候。
But when we move him away from our center,
就是祸害临到的时候。
Then that's when trouble will come.
所以我们祈祷，也这我觉得这个信心对我很有很大的提醒。
I feel like this is a great reminder for me.
我们就举个例子好了，我在大学的时候。
For example, when I was back in college,
我把设计看重于神。
I put design above God.
我为了设计不睡觉。
In order to design, I would not sleep.
我为了设计不好好聚会。
And to design, I will skip our fellowship.
我为了设计不好好服侍。
For design, I will not serve.
结果我花了好几个小时设计的东西。
Then the design I spent countless hours on.
被教授骂得粪土不如。
Then my professor will scold at me.
这时候我好好回转向神。
This is when I turn go back to God.
神啊，求你帮助我。
God, please help me.
你是我的王，你是我的神。
You are my God.
请你带领我走出这个混乱。
Please lead me through this path.
有很多人看，也有很多人看到了。
Many people see this.
很多人看到这个，其中有带我读圣经的弟兄们也看到这件事情。
Many brothers saw this my past.
当我好好聚会的时候
，When I fellowship accordingly.
好好服侍
，When I serve accordingly.
好好敬畏神读经的时候
，And then read the Bible and fellowship.
把神放我的中心的时候
，When I put God in my center.
我又气又高兴
，I was angry yet happy.
因为我三个小时的设计。被学校斩出去了。
Because I only spent merely 3 hours on design, then the school would display it.
但是我花了好几天的设计，被教授骂了，非常非常难堪。
But then, if I spent days on the design, then my professor would embarrass me.
所以我才发现，一切都是出于耶和华。
Therefore, I learned everything comes from Jehovah.
所以其实有时候患难临到我们的时候，我觉得也是个祝福。
Actually, when trouble comes upon us, I think this is a blessing.
对我们来讲是歹。
Although many times we feel like we're getting punished,
但是对我们对神来讲是好。
But for God, this is good.
因为这个患难
，because it's trouble,
我们更接近了神。
Will bring us closer to God.
我们更了解自己的堕落。
Will make us remember our downfall more.
其实有不只是这段时间我会敬畏神，还有一个非常重要的 moment 我会敬畏神。
Not only this time period I honor the Lord, but also another period I honor the Lord.
我拉肚子的时候。我不常拉肚子。
When I have stomach problem, but I don't have them often.
但是那时候我觉得我跟神的距离是最近的。
But
抱在怀里的近。
But at that time, I feel so.
我开始会想说神啊，我做了什么事情？我一直反复了 examine myself.
But I would examine myself, asking what have I done wrong?
师傅在吃饼杯的时候、喝饼杯的时候没有好好祷告，没有好好纪念他的身体、他的血。
Is it because I didn't pray properly during the communion?
是不是我做事不老实？是不是我没有聚会？是不是我今天说了一些东西，然后得罪弟兄姐妹们
？Was it me being unfaithful or said something that have offended somebody?
但最后结论是神啊，求你救我。
But the conclusion is, Lord, please save me.
我在厕所有哭过，真的太痛了，你知道吗
？I actually even cried in the bathroom.
然后这时候我突然想到
，But then I remember.
然后我就突然想到感谢神，因为。这件小事情让我纪念神的恩典。
But then I thank him because through such a small event, I got to remember him.
让我想到我自己有多么的恶劣。
Let me remember how evil I am.
然后非常像列王记上下的故事，我之后还是犯罪了。
But just like the stories in the First Kings, I continue.
所以下次拉肚子的时候，我哭得更伤心。
So next time when I have stomach problems.
神啊，我真的错了，我劝你不要拉肚子了。
I confess I have wronged. Now please help me.
就这样子一次一次的循环。
Then this cycle continues.
但是每一次神都恩典。
But then the Lord is always gracious to us.
这边有许多敬畏神的人。
There are many people that reveres God.
其中一个我自己猜，他敬畏神是因为他常常拉肚子。
There's one that also just like me, because he has.
因为他见他不在，所以我介绍他一下。
He's not here today, so I can talk about him.
他不在吗？他不在。对。那最近听说他不拉肚子了。
I heard he doesn't have stomach problems.
我们愿神的旨意继续成全在他身上。
May the God's will continue to be on him.
求神怜悯我们。
May the Lord have mercy on us.
不是说他拉肚子，希望还有更多的提醒在我们身上。
That through all these events, may the Lord remind us of him.
我们也希望神不是只是给我们富裕，或是贫穷。
Help us remember, God doesn't only give us riches or poverty.
而只赐给我们当日我们所用的。
But he only give us our daily bread.
好像我们不会得罪他，忘记他。
So that we do not forget his name.
这是我在《历代至上》这本书所分享的。
This is my little sharing in the First King.
谢谢。
Thank you. Peace to you, brothers and sisters.
记得去年分享的时候是四月份。
I remember last year I shared it was April.
一年多了。
It's about a year, over a year.
去年分享的时候还在找工作。
Last year I was still job hunting.
我记得当时我说要接受神摆在我面前的任何一件。
I shared I would receive whatever God had portioned me.
我记得当时神摆在我面前的就是可能要去香港。
Then God has placed me back then. I thought I was going to Hong Kong.
还好没去。
Thankfully, I didn't go.
很难想到这一年，现在。
It's hard to believe that throughout this year.
这这么快就过去了。
It went by so fast.
而且我现在做的事儿也是我小时候从来没有想过的。
And what I'm doing now is something I never dreamed of when I was a kid.
每个人小时候都会有梦想嘛，想做什么。
We all have dreams as a kid.
我曾经想过想做过很多事儿。
I wanted to do many things.
曾经想过做机械工程。
Maybe engineer.
做律师。
Lawyer.
设计。
Designer.
做投行。
Investor.
种地。
Or farmer.
酿酒。
Or be a brewer.
这其实种地和酿酒都还有可能啊。
But farmer or having a brewery is still possible.
但是唯一没有想到的
，But the only thing I didn't think of，
就是会在开发房地产
，is in a real estate investor。
更没有想到的
，even less so，
就是会参加创业
，is that in a entrepreneur。
创业这事儿就先不说了。
I'll skip the entrepreneur portion。
我觉得以后肯定还会有机会再分享。
Maybe I'll have other opportunities。
今天先讲讲我这个。正业的这个公司。
Let me just talk about my investing company.
我在这个公司真的是实在是很感觉到蒙福。
I feel really blessed in this company.
因为我们公司基本上就大部分人都是基督徒。
Because most of my colleagues are Christians.
而且都是比较好的基督徒，比较有追求的。
They're Christians that are actually pretty good Christians.
其实讲一个故事吧。
Let me just tell a story.
有一个周日
，This is one Sunday。
我们公司五六个人出去，也不是出去，去一个同事家吃饭。
Five or six of us went to a coworker's house to eat。
然后呢，大家都基本上到齐了，就差那么一两个人。
We're almost all there. There's a couple of two people missing。
等这个最后进来这个人出现的时候呢
，When the last person showed up，
蹦蹦跳跳的，特高兴。
He was dancing around. He was so cheerful。
然后他说了一句话。
He says,
他问，猜我们今天传道人讲的什么
？He said, guess what our preacher shared today.
我们都说啊，不知道啊。
We said, no, I don't know.
然后他说，他讲的乐园里有没有市场经济？
啊？
in paradise? Is there a market economy?
In paradise, is there a market economy?
然后我们就就这个话题讲了，聊了得有一个多两个小时。
And for this topic, we talked about discussed about 2 hours.
然后不止这个，当时还有两个非基督徒在，就是朋友。
But there are two non-Christians among us.
然后又有个机会给他们传传福音。
But we also use this opportunity to share the gospel.
这种话题其实在办公室里也经常发生。
This kind of topic happens quite often in an office.
就觉得现在过上了一种幸福的日子。
I feel like my life is really blessed.
前一阵子就突然想起来刘叔老说的一句话。
A few weeks back, I remember what Uncle Peter often shared.
就是说，要经常为自己以后的服事准备自己。
That you have to often prepare yourself for the services to come.
所以我就立志要好好下功夫预备自己。
So I promise that I will prepare myself.
然后呢，我今天其实想跟大家分享的一个就是。我最近的一些学习。
But then what I want to share with brothers and sisters today is what I have learned recently.
在工作岗位上，怎么样给神做见证
？How can we be a testimony in our office？
这在教会待的时间久一点的人都听过。
People who been in the church for a while all heard about this.
但是我觉得我是刚刚开始学。
Because I think I'm just new at my job.
所以可能可以给大家稍微有点回忆一下当时的感受吧。
So maybe I can refresh your memory.
对我来说，我觉得秘诀就在哥林多，不是哥罗西书三章。
For me, I think the secret is in the Colossians chapter 3.
22-25
Verses 22-25.
22-25说。
The verses say,
你们做仆人的要凡事听从你们肉身的主人。不要只在眼前侍奉，像是讨人喜欢的，总要存心诚实敬畏主。
Okay, verse 22. Slaves, obey your earthly masters in everything, and do it not only when their eyes is on you and to curry their favor, but with sincerity of heart and reverence for the Lord.
无论做什么，都要从心里做，像是给主做的，不是给人做的。
Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for human masters.
因为你们知道，从主那里必得着基业为赏赐。你们所侍奉的乃是主基督。
Since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward, it is the Lord Christ you are serving.
那行不义的必受不义的报应。主并不偏待人。
Anyone who does wrong will be repaid for their wrongs, and there is no favoritism.
是的。是想跟大家分享一下的。
There are a couple points that I want to share.
第一就是不要只在眼前服侍，像是讨人喜欢的。
The first is don't just serve in front of people, just try to win their favor.
总要存心诚实敬畏主。
But serve the Lord with reverence of heart.
其实我觉得在工作上能荣耀神的事儿说多也挺多的，说少其实也没几样。
I think at the job place.Things that can glorify the God. If you want to say there's a lot, there's quite a bit. But if you want to say there's not much, there's also not much.
把工作做好，是不是可以荣耀神
？Be faithful to your task. Can that glorify God?
Being successful.
Oh, being successful.
Task.
On your task. Is that glorifying?
当然可以。
Yes.
但是任何一个人都可以把工作做好。
But anyone can be successful at their work.
也有无数个原因，有理由可以。让你把工作做好。
There are many factors or reasons that can make you successful at your work.
可以讨老板喜欢。
You can win a favor for your boss.
有奖金。
Extra bonus.
为了面子。
To earn face.
或者甚至是让自己下一个项目能够顺利一点。
Or to be more fluent in your next task.
这是我干过。
This is just a few reasons.
I've done this before.
Oh, I've done all these before.
但是基督徒要做的是无论有没有原因？有没有眼前的利益
？But for Christians, whatever your doubt,
不是为了工作。
Not just for your boss, not just for the work itself.
我说的不是为了老板负责，也不是为了你的工作负责。
You're not just trying to be faithful to your boss or the work at hand.
你是要向神负责。
But you need to be faithful to the Lord.
比如说，有时候，经常其实这种事情经常发生，就是上司会给我一个我觉得完全没有意义的工作。
For example, my boss would assign me something that I feel there's absolutely no purpose.
比如说，做一个 model。
For example, make a model.
然后我那个数学模型写好了，然后他告诉我说，你把这个数据的表格用一张照片再贴上去。
Boswell say, well, once I complete the mathematical formula, and then
copy a picture onto it.
And then copy a picture onto it.
然后就觉得，好吧。
I thought to myself, okay.
这个我要做，直接 copy paste.
For me, copy and paste is easy.
一分钟，两分钟。
A minute or two.
但是我觉得要把它做好，要把它整整齐齐的放上去，有把它，虽然我觉得没有意义，但是我可以把它变得有意义的话呢，可能要花半个小时。
Although I feel this task is meaningless, but if I want to do it right and make it presentable, this may take up half an hour of my time.
这就难了。
Then this will be tough.
但是我觉得，神要我们做的就是，要理解老板的心意，就像我们理解他的心意一样。
But what the Lord is asking us is to understand the heart of the boss, like we understand the heart of our God.
因为你不知道神要什么的话，你永远不能给他。
Because if you don't know what God wants, you can never do what He wants.
下一件事。
Next task.
就是无论做什么要从心里做。
No matter what you do, needs to be from the heart.
这从心里做，中文翻译的不是特别恰当。
From the heart, the Chinese translation isn't all that accurate.
这个从心里做，其实就是要有怎么说呢？就是很努力的去做。
Say from the something that's from the heart, that means you really have to try hard.
而且很积极的去做。
And do it, work on it diligently.
就像刚才那个前面一个题目，就类似的。
Just like the top the.Topic I was talking about before.
每个人其实都其他的东西看得重。
We all have different priorities.
会更努力。
That we emphasize on, we work on harder.
但是大部分人也都知道，基本上所有人都知道，这不应该这样。
But most people know that this shouldn't be.
什么事情都应该努力做。
That in theory, everything should be done diligently.
你最常听到的，我这个是一个英文的一个 cliche, 所以我翻译一下，让 Henry 就比较。
That's an English cliche.
值得做的就值得做得好。
What's worth doing is worth doing right.
Right. 然后还有就是我比较喜欢引用的一个人。
And then this person I like to give example.
60年代赢了很多次橄榄球冠军的球队的教练。
As this coach, this football coach in the 60s that won many awards, championship.
Vince Lombardi.
Vince Lombardi.
他有一句话。
He said one thing.
如果你在追求你极限的时候，你从不妥协。
If you are searching for, if you will not settle for anything less than your best, you will be amazed at what you can accomplish in your lives.
你会惊讶你一生能做成什么。
You will be amazed at what you can accomplish in your lives.
这些人都知道。
Everybody knows.
那对基督徒来说，任何一件事背后的动力
，For a Christian, the motivation behind everything we do,
都是为了向主负责。
It should be towards God.
所以努力和动力应该也都是一样的。
So our motivation and determination should be the same.
你做的一件事情
，Everything that something that you do,
不管是你喜欢做的还是不喜欢做的
，Whether you like it or not,
你觉得有意义没有意义
，Whether you think it has a purpose or not.
神要做的，神要我们做到的。
If God wants us to do it,
就是把它做好。
Then we do it right.
这样，我觉得我们最终的盼望
，then our desire,
是能让神能行神的旨意而得到满足。
Is to do the will of God and be satisfied.
我们不知道下面的路神会怎么带领。
We don't know how God will lead us in the days to come.
但是我现在我觉得有点明白。
But now I have a little understanding.
我觉得在生活的每一个层面上
，In every level of our lives,
都要尽自己的本能。
We are supposed to do what we're supposed to do.
才能满足他的要求。
Can we satisfy his desire?
工作
，Our job.
学习
，Education.
家庭
，Family.
穿衣服
，Or clothing.
都一样。
It's all the same.
你努力。
You try hard.
认识神要什么。
You have to diligently try to know what God wants.
这样才能够满足他的要求。
Can we satisfy his desires?
好，分享就这些，谢谢。
That's my little sharing.
弟兄姐妹平安。
Peace to you, brothers and sisters.
我想要分享一个不是好的基督徒的故事。
I want to share you with a story of a bad Christian.
在我刚认识主的时候
，When I first came to know the Lord，
去一个查经班
，I went to a Bible study。
一个查经班的姐妹，她有一点分享，让我当时觉得很奇怪。
And then a sister shared a story that puzzled me。
她说我已经记不清她的原话具体是怎样讲。
I forgot exactly how she worded。
她的大体意思是说，我们每个人都想做超凡优秀的人。
But basically, what she's saying is every one of us want to be a supernatural Christian,
extraordinary
person.
对，然后但是在主里面，我们需要尽力做到 ordinary, 平凡。
But in the Lord, we actually be an ordinary person.
然后还有一位弟兄在他后面补充说。
But then a brother added onto her sharing.
他说，在这个世界上，我们每个人都想要争当第一。
In this world, everybody is fighting for number one.
但是主却让我们做最后的那一个。
But the Lord wants us to be the last one.
当时我还没有受洗，不能理解。
Back then I wasn't baptized, so couldn't understand.
我还住在纽约。
I was in New York City.
在这个城市里，每天走在大街上。
In this city, I walked around the blocks, the road every day.
你都可以看到很多大牌子，像 "Amazing things are happening here."
You can see lots of signs that are saying amazing things are happening here.
或者是 be extraordinary 这样。
Or words that says be extraordinary.
甚至每个人走在街上都是好像是在往前冲而不是往前走。
Or like everybody walking that striving forward instead of walking forward.
当时我听了这个分享觉得很奇怪，为什么主耶稣要让基督徒做一群不思进取的人？
So after the sharing, I thought, why does Jesus want us to just be an ordinary person?
感谢主，虽然我有很多的疑问，最后还是很乐意的受洗。
Although I still had a lot of questions, but thankfully I was baptized.
主也一步一步的带领我学习要学的功课。
And then Lord led me a step at a time to learn the homework I have to learn.
跟很多有孩子的弟兄姐妹分享。
And I had a chance to share with many brothers and sisters who had children.
大家都讲好像是家里的老大比较容易有各种各样。
They all share that seems like all their first child have all the problems.
很不幸，我也是家里的老大。
Unfortunately, I'm also a first child.
不管是从家人的教导，还是学校的社会，我们所处的社会的教育。
Whether from social education or home education.
我们从小就被灌输要优秀，要进取。
We have been brainwashed that we had to be number one, we had to be successful.
我也是在很多事情上都不自觉的想要要强。
In many things, I unintentionally realize I want to be strong.
我很希望事情都能做得好。
I want everything to be done right.
潜意识里可能是希望别人看到我做得好，自己会有一种成就感。
Maybe subconsciously, I want people to recognize me.
甚至我有时候我会把这种积极上进带到信仰里面来。
And then I will take this mindset.Into our religion.
好像表面上看起来我查经很积极。
So from the surface, people may think I'm really diligently reading the Bible.
好像短讲准备的还挺充分。
Or maybe the short sharing I prepared well.
好像服侍的时候还很用心。
Or when I serve, I'm really serve full heartedly.
但是我觉得，其实内心深处有很大一部分是因为我害怕别人觉得我做的不好。
But deep down in my heart, I fear people may think.I'm not performing well.
就好像在等待判成绩的老师，担心自己不是一个好的学生。
It's like waiting for my grades to come out, thinking that I'm a bad student.
甚至这种崇尚优秀的这种态度，会影响到我与人的交相处。
So this success-oriented attitude impact my dealing with people.
会让我变得对人很苛刻。
And so you allow me makes me hard.
不仅要求自己，要求别人。
So that not only do I have strong strong judgment not only on myself and also on other people.
感谢主，他兴起各样的环境来让我学习。
I thank the Lord for raising many different circumstances for me to learn.
有一次，我的一位慕道的朋友初尝主恩的滋味。
One of my non-Christian friends asked me.
他信心满满的给我发消息说，我觉得我现在学圣经学得很好。
Full of faith, he said.He sent me a text saying, "I think I'm doing well learning the Bible."
但是讲这话的时候，他现在都他甚至还都没有要参加受洗班。
But when he was sending me this message, he didn't want to join the baptismal class.
我仿佛看到自己的影子。
So I saw my shadow there.
主对我主让我学习的功课主要是通过很多服事上的挫败。
The Lord let me learn many spiritual lessons through serving and failures of serving.
在过去的两年里面，我有机会参加一些儿童的服事。
In the past 2 years, I had the opportunity to join the children ministry.
我有在中文学校教教手工课。
I taught craft in Chinese school.
我根本就不会做什么手工课。当时我接过这个服事，是因为中文学校老师说没有人可以做，他们希望我可以帮忙。
Actually, I have no experience in crafting. I was asked to serve because there was nobody else.
我其实根本就没有很多的能力。我答应也只是因为想说别人都已经问我了，我怎么可能拒绝？
I have no talent whatsoever. I only agreed because somebody else asked me, and I didn't want to say no.
而且潜意识里肯定我还有一部分，我想我自己肯定还有一部分是想说，那既然我去学，我可能会有这个能力，能把它教好。
And then subconsciously, I thought to myself, if I learn this, then I can definitely teach it.
第一年非常的混乱。
First year was chaotic.
我的课上第一年是因为有很多不同年龄的小孩，我永远都记得在课上总是有孩子横着，有孩子竖着，有孩子在走。
Because my class was full of kids with different age range, so they come in all different size and shape.
我每个星期天的下午，我好像不知道为什么脸都是拉得很长。聚会完之后
，every afternoon, every Sunday afternoon, I have a long face.
但是，因为于是我就对自己说
，So I thought to myself,
这是第一次，因为我没有经验，我没有接触过小孩，所以我会总结我失败的教训。
So I said to myself, this is just the first time, I didn't have experience, so therefore this is why I have failed.
但是在这中间我好像祷告读经的祷告的次数从来很少。
But in the midst of this failure, I realized my prayer was minimal.
我不断地总结自己课上的经验，还总是去学习各种各样跟小孩有关的这些无论是心理还是技能上的那些知识。
So my conclusion was the lack of experience. So I spent extra time to learn how to deal with children.
然后第二年。
So in the second year.
第二年两堂课的小孩子年龄都比较统一。
Then the two classes I taught, their age group are much closer.
但是我还是非常的混乱。
But it was still very chaotic.
我记得有一次，我居然好像非常脆弱的被。第一节课的小男孩给气哭了。
And then actually once, I was actually one of the little boys made me cry.
还有一次，有一个小男孩直接走过来跟我讲。
And so actually, there's another time a little boy came to me and said.
他说：“你老公什么时候再来教
？”When is your husband going to come and teach?
我们觉得他比较有趣。
We think he's more fun.
就是这样，我觉得，那一段时间我的心情非常的。非常的低。
And because of this, my emotion was very low, down.
我真的觉得不管是有意的还是无意的，我现在真的不行。
But whether consciously or subconsciously, I feel like I'm incapable.
有我忘了是谁说，他说在你做一件事情将要放弃的时候，就是你要进步的时候。
I forgot who said it, but that person said when you're about to give up, this is the time you are about to improve.
我觉得在主里也是这样。每当我们意识到自己是多么的软弱、不行的时候
，I feel the same in the Lord. Whenever we feel we're so weak and unable to continue.
主恩就是我们主恩彰显的时候。
This is the beginning of God's grace.
我也不记得具体是什么时间，反正就是借着一次一次的查经，还有聚会。
I don't remember exactly when, but through Bible studying week after week.
通过这件事情让我看到，原来我好像真的在什么方面都不行。
Through this event, God let me see I'm incapable.
主借着这件事情拿掉我这些渴望优秀，或者是拿掉我这些包袱。
And through these things, God removed my success-oriented mentality and burden.
让我意识到，原来什么事情都是要来抱主的大腿。
Let me realize everything that I need to ask the Lord for help.
我并没有在儿童服事上有现在有长进多少，或者是情况要改善多少。
I'm not saying the circumstances in the children ministry have improved much.
但是我能够感觉到我心里跟之前的不同。
But I can realize there's a change of heart in me.
之前因为我的一些苛刻或者是性格方面的缺陷。
Because of my personality flaws.
我很容易不喜欢一个人。
It's easy for me to not like somebody.
但是我现在很满足在主里面做一个普普通通的肢体。
But right now I'm really satisfied being an ordinary person.In God's kingdom.
所有的弟兄姐妹在我的眼里真心的觉得非常的可爱。
I do find everybody and sister really cute. Adorable.
不再会有论断自己论断别人的那些痛苦。
So I don't have the burden of criticizing other people.
就像我们今天诗歌里唱的主赐我软弱仰望他的恩典。
Just like the hymn we sang today, God, through our weakness, God showed us His grace.
他叫贫穷的富足，他叫低贱的升高。
He brought up the low and made rich the poor.
所以在主里，我们不害怕做最笨的那个。
So in the Lord, we're not afraid to be the most foolish one.
因为在他里面有最丰富的智慧。
Because in Him we have the richest wisdom.
我们也不怕做最后最吃亏的那一个。
And also, we're not afraid to be the last.
因为在主里，我们有最平静的安息。
Because in Him, we have the most satisfying peace.
这就是我的分享。
This is my little sharing.
谢谢。
很高兴听见这些弟兄姐妹的分享。
We are glad to hear the sharing from the brothers and sisters this afternoon.
没有高言大志。
We do not have great words.
但是看见他们实际实质上的进步。
But we see.